There are two types of Sigma male, the Ronin and the Wizard. Which one are you? Find out. Kaiju Pack, what's up? It's your boy Kaiju Kong. Now before I begin, if this video helped you in any way, if you learned something new or gained a new perspective, even if it made you feel better, all I ask is that you leave a like and subscribe to this channel. If you feel the message will help a friend or family member, then do share the video with them. Thanks in advance, guys, and let's dive into the topic. The Sigma Male, the Lone Wolf, the Solitary Hunter, the Silent Storm. There are two reasons why one becomes a Sigma. If you identify as a Sigma Male, then you can relate to either one of these two paths. It will help you to know which one you fall in, as self-understanding allows you to identify how you can best contribute to the world in a way that only you can. This, of course, also saves time and effort from fighting a battle you are not built for. Just recently was the term Sigma Male popularized. Before this, there existed only the Alpha and the Beta, which left quite a lot of men confused and unsure of themselves because they did not exactly fit in the description of neither the Alpha nor the Beta. Furthermore, participation in the social hierarchy was an obligation, otherwise you were seen in a bad light, branded as an outcast or someone rather strange. With the recent propagation of the Sigma Male archetype as a viable and rather competitive way to live, a classification was opened to those who did not quite fit in. Those who, in traditional society, were branded as either Alpha or Beta, but felt that there was more. You were most likely the same and began as either an Alpha or a Beta. So here we go. The first type of Sigma Male started from a place of power. I call him the Ronin, the wandering samurai who serves no lord. In the social hierarchy, he is seen as an Alpha, yet not as loud nor arrogant. Instead, he possesses intelligence and is socially mature. He possesses many traits of the Alpha, but deep down never felt comfortable doing all the Alpha things. He can lead, but doesn't like ordering people around. He could be built to fight, but would rather use cunning or diplomacy to avoid confrontations whenever possible. Above all, though he is charismatic, he's not an extrovert and prefers to recharge by himself. The reason he prefers to go his own way is because through social intelligence, he eventually realizes the many faults in society, the pretentiousness and superficiality of it all, and recognizes that to truly harness his true potential as a man, he has to separate from the chains of the herd mentality. He sees the bigger picture and prefers to take on the larger forces that move the world than to face mere mortals. Fully developed, they became the legendary warriors of history. Today, there are many of the top athletes, businessmen, and celebrities. Now this is the first type and first path of Sigma Male. The second type of Sigma Male started from a place of weakness. I call him the Wizard, by all considered bizarre and is often underestimated until tested. In the social hierarchy, the Wizard comes across to others as a Beta, because he is either physically unimposing or is socially awkward. However, he compensates for his lack in some certain outstanding way. He could be extremely intelligent in a certain field, or as they call, a savant of sorts. He is socially awkward because he cannot verbalize the intricacies of his complicated mind. He prefers to reflect on theories, develop on ideas, and innovate rather than participate in the mindless, everyday ho-hums of society. The reason he goes his own way is very much like the reasons of the Ronin, but in many cases, this separation from society was not a choice he made. He was made an outcast by society itself. He did not have the choice. So he uses the time in solitude to invent, develop, and build. Fully developed, they became the philosophers, painters, and the great inventors in history. Today, they become well-known artists, authors, professors, scientists, and entrepreneurs. I will end with this. An Alpha is someone of high value. Men want to be him, and women want to be with him. Even if you started on the path as a beta or wizard, becoming a powerful Sigma male guarantees you will end up an alpha. Why? Because instead of wasting time on the largely useless activities of average people, you use that spare time to master, hone in on, and develop your respective skills and talents. And as a result, you do indeed become very valuable. You evolve into a specialist or a very impressive jack of all trades. But above all, you have to be competitive. You must have the fire to succeed. Otherwise, you'll just be spending the spare time toward no definite goal. Be smart, think long term, and develop in silence, brothers. Think of it this way. A caterpillar that never closes itself off from the world to work on itself never becomes a butterfly. If you aim to grow to your full potential as a Sigma male, then subscribe and hit the notifications button to stay connected as a member of the Kaiju Pack. More videos are on their way. Please don't forget to leave a like on the way out. This will support the channel's growth and help many more men out there. And with that, this gathering is concluded. Thank you for joining me. Take care, brothers.